Another field that's expected to experience a worker shortage is welding, making those with that skill set in high demand. A projected welder deficit of 375,000 is expected to hit by 2023. Instructors at Haney Technical Center say they're trying to get the word out about the welding industry. News 13's Emily McLeod is live in our studios tonight. Emily, it wasn't too long ago that Haney was ranked one of the top welding programs in the country.
Amy, instructors say that ranking gave Haney's welding program a lot of attention, and it brought in a lot of people from out of state. Some students have no experience, and their teachers are able to show them the tricks of the trade so they can land a job after completing the program.
Students in Haney Technical Center's welding program say dedication is needed to be successful in the field.
You have to have it, or your welds aren't going to look as good, or you're just not going to get it any time. And you can't blame others besides yourself, really.
Welding student Noah Salazar says he spends at least 6 hours a day working on his craft.
First, it was pretty difficult learning how to do a stick part, and then it started getting easier and easier. It's all about practice. You burn as much rod, as many rods as you can, all day, every day.
Cameron Fender is also a student of the program. Fender got his bachelor's degree before realizing welding was the right path for him.
You drop your hood, there's no one around you to bother you. Overall, it's just you, and you're just welding. So that's what I love most about it, is that you don't really have a whole bunch of people bothering you. You're just over there and just doing your own thing.
Currently, there is a projected welder deficit that's expected to reach 375,000 by 2023.
And it's been that way. I've been involved in welding for 40 years, and it's always been, that way. We have done a real poor job of educating enough people in any of the trades, but welding in particular.
Eric Johnson is a welding instructor at Haney Technical Center. He encourages people to keep an open mind about attending a trade school rather than a college or university.
Parents need to be open to the fact that, all kids are not going to college. And also, then one fact that's overlooked a lot, not just in welding, but all the trades we have here, there's also college careers attached to it. And we've had students that's come through as high schoolers, didn't have any idea about going into welding, who are now welding engineers.
Johnson says it's rare when students who graduate from their program don't end up with jobs.
For the last time we checked, we had students in 22 different states working and 4 different countries.
Students of the welding program also say their instructors are always encouraging them to get better and help them believe in themselves. Haney Technical Center does not require prior experience in order to be enrolled in their welding program. Amy?
Thanks, Emily.